So it's a Jacobean manor. There's loads of history here, owned by the Sabine Baring Gould family. Various parts of the hotel have been built in different time frames. I took a chef de partie job here about 4.5 years ago, just because I wanted to get into the building, wanted to get into the company. Quickly worked my way up the ladder. I was sort of sous chef within 18 months, and then I continued to be sous chef under my old head chef, Matthew Perrier, for about 2.5, almost 3 years. And I've kind of been cooking for realistically about 10 years. And sort of as I've gone through my career, I've kind of developed not just a knowledge for food, but sort of this love for sort of West Country ingredients and Devon ingredients. The food down in the Southwest is the best that you can get. The water's amazing, the farms are amazing, the vegetables are amazing. You know, we've got this phenomenal vegetable garden 100 foot away that we use and we get everything out of, and develop dishes from the produce that we get. I think finding the quality ingredients is more important than deciding on what you want to cook. If we save ourselves money on things like vegetables and things that we're growing ourselves, and we can spend more money on quality beef and lamb. I have an amazing relationship with my meat supplier. They're just down the road. They use only West Country produce, Devon, Cornish. It's all from fairly close by farms. I can find out any piece of information. So with the feather blade, what we do is, firstly, when it comes in, we make sure we've got a good quality product. Take the feather blade and we take the big layer of fat off the top, and then we take the gristle out of the centre, almost like filleting a fish. So we take the gristle out of the centre, portion it into sort of like 3-portion chunks, and we vacuum pack it with olive oil, garlic, thyme and rosemary, and then a little bit of black pepper as well, corns, and then sous vide that for 22 hours at 68.5 degrees. So the reason we sous vide it is it's quite a tough piece of meat, and it's the type of meat that you either want to cook really hot and fast or really long and slow. Our water bath is our only real technical piece of equipment, so we utilise it as much as we can for things like that. So cooking the meat at that temperature for that long means it stays pink in the centre, but it also breaks down the proteins in the meat, so that when it's almost like eating a braised piece of meat that's still got the colour and flavour of a piece of meat that's just been pan fried or roasted in the oven. Once we've finished sous vide it, we roast it to get that colour, to get that flavour. And once we've done that, we drop it into a red wine jus and glaze it, so it gets all sticky on the outside. But again, you have to be really careful that you're not overcooking the meat in that process. So the beetroot carpaccio, what we do is we take the beetroots from the garden, take purple beetroots, and we slice them really, really thin on a mandolin. So we just pickle it really, really lightly just to take the edge off. We lay that on the plate, 9 pieces, sort of 9 discs in a nice square. We put the braised beef that we've topped with candied walnuts and some chives on there with a little bit of horseradish mash, using potatoes from the garden, horseradish from the garden. And then we roast off some golden beetroots. And then on top of that dish, we do a crispy beef tendon. So we take beef tendon and we pressure cook them for 90 minutes, put them in the fridge, chill them down for 12 hours, slice them very, very thin, dehydrate them, and then drop them into 190 degree oil, which means they puff up and go almost like a pork scratching, but using the beef. And then we top them with a beetroot powder and a horseradish powder. So the reason I love blade so much is it's got so much flavour, and if you cook it right, it's got an amazing texture. For the purposes of this dish, it's a little bit extra to have a piece of meat that actually tastes like you're eating a piece of meat, as opposed to the fact of putting fillet on the menu because it's fillet.